Respected Prime Minister Ji, I am Muralidharan, President of Harbor Mandal of Central Chennai District. My question is, by doing the Mahagathbandhan, will these parties be able to save themselves from the past sins? Do they consider us fools? What do you say on this, sir?
Muralidhar, you are right. Today, several leaders are talking about a grand alliance or a Mahagathbandhan. This alliance is for personal survival, not ideology-based support. This alliance is for power, not for the people. This alliance is for personal ambitions, not people's aspirations. Do you know, several of these parties and their leaders claim to be deeply inspired by Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia, who was deeply opposed to the Congress, its ideology, and the way Congress did politics. What sort of a tribute are they paying to Dr. Lohia by forming an unholy and opportunist alliance with the Congress? Dr. Lohia always said, the Congress is a compromise party which had made compromises on many ideological issues, national interest issues. He also said that Congress is responsible for caste inequality in India. Dr. Lohia was pained that the Congress after 1947 was not the Congress of Mahatma Gandhi, but it had leaders who got used to power and luxury. The top leadership of several parties who are now aiming for a seat on the Mahagathbandhan were arrested and tortured during the emergency. Sadly, today these parties and Congress have become oxygen for each other. But people know very well the real nature of these parties. Whenever they are in power, be it Uttar Pradesh or Bihar, the state sees complete breakdown of law and order. Corrupt and criminal elements are supreme when these parties govern. It is common knowledge how the Congress harassed Mulayam Singh Ji with cases. Have these parties done justice to the ideals of Dr. Lohia? The answer is resounding no, no, no. Congress and their ecosystem spares no one. Even the great MGR, the stalwart who worked for the poor and downtrodden, was targeted. In 1980, his elected government was dismissed. He had the support of the assembly, the house of the people, but Congress had the Raj Bhavan, house of the governor. Fresh elections were called and MGR won. Srimati Indira Gandhi never forgave MGR for that. No one has forgotten where the Congress and DMK stood on the Jain Commission. That time, Congress said, either it is DMK or it is us. But today, they want to be together. If not opportunism, what explains their alliance? In Andhra Pradesh, it was NTR, NT Rama Rao, who faced the anger and high-headedness of the Congress. He formed a party for the pride and respect of the Telugus at a time when the Congress humiliated a chief minister of Andhra Pradesh. Yet, today the party of NTR wants to ally with the Congress. How can the people of Andhra Pradesh accept this? It was not long ago that the left was passing resolutions calling Congress pro-imperialist, responsible for price rise, agriculture crisis, and much more. But now they sing false praise of each other. Another party, based in Maharashtra, was formed in severe opposition to the Congress leadership. But they ran Maharashtra for 15 years with Congress, looted the state with Congress, did irrigation scam with Congress, did other scam with Congress. Maximum farmer suicides happened when this party, along with Congress, was holding the agriculture portfolio. The truth is, this so-called Grand Alliance are a club of rich dynasties. They're only to promise family rule. People can see through their opportunism and will never accept such an incoherent coalition. India wants democracy. The alliance wants dynasty. India wants growth for all. The alliance wants growth for only their families.